Have you entered the Temple of Solomon? And what is the Temple of Solomon? We're going to look at your piece from an alchemical perspective and do a little lesson on reading symbolisms. I hope you find this interesting. Let's notice opposites here. Christ is pointing in opposite directions. There's a black bird on the left and a white bird on the right. On the right is the word life, and on the left is someone sick in bed. There are candlesticks, and there is a definite difference between the world below the hands of Christ and above the hands of Christ. On the right is a symbol of someone in a chair, which is judgment, and on the left is a dragon, someone being bitten by the dragon. You are part of a tree, and you have a fish on you that is dead. There is also a baby upside down, and there is a communication that we have gone through a major pole shift, meaning we have flipped from an underworld or an upside down world to a right side up world, and we went through this pole shift like a thief in the night. And so welcome to the new world, and welcome to the new way of behaving and thinking. It's a slow process of this awakening, but those who hear the voice, you're going to be stepping into your gifts, and it will go along with your passion, thankfully. You are the protector of the innocent. You are protecting a daisy and a heart. If you look throughout this piece, Solomon with the letter S, with the wreath on his head, is protecting an innocent child that looks like a Christmas tree. On your left hand is going through a portal. This means that your double self shifts through time. The self of you that is in the physical must hold on to life energy and things that grow and thoughts that are innocent, in order for your higher self, which is the white dove and the person that is seated on the judgment chair, to do their job. So flesh and spirit have to work together. We're going to take notice of all the things that are white. This is the white mother goose at 1 o'clock, the white horse at 6 o'clock, the white bed sheets at 7 o'clock, and the white peacock at 11 o'clock. It goes around like 1, 6, 7, and 11. The two lights are between 3 and 9 o'clock, and they are like a gateway. And this gateway is known as the two pillars of Solomon's temple. When we have entered Solomon's temple, we have gone through a pole shift. And the sun is now dominating our ego. The Holy Spirit dominates the flesh. And we will begin stepping into an awakening that will lead us to an adepthood if we persist in all efforts. So you are being given a certificate, an invisible certificate, saying, congratulations, you have entered a realm where you will learn to use your double for the will of God. Let us begin talking about the symbologies in your piece. At 1 o'clock, there is the white bird. It is both the holy dove and the mother goose. This reflects a mother energy like Emaya or the goddess Haya that has entered into our consciousness. It seems as if we went and lived through the body of Christ and have entered into a new body. And this new body is a new world. The body of Christ was the entire age of Pisces. So you are seated and you have a crown with the number 5 on it, holding a treasure box. And this is a time of our consciousness bouncing to a higher dimension, like a thief in the night. And our heads go up like a rainbow bridge to our godhood. It's as if our flesh finally becomes one with our higher self, spirit. So the two rainbow people are flanking both sides of the judge. When we move down from there, we see a pretty little flower with the word life and a token. The token is from the myth of Ur. The Lady Necessity gives people tokens as to whether they go to a higher realm or lower realm in a near-death experience. We do not experience death, unless you remember a near-death experience. We only remember a pole shift. So there is a person who has died with the same crown as the person who is at 2 o'clock. This means that the person who's seated on the throne has died and has their consciousness has gone up like a rainbow. And the token from the Lady of Necessity is a token of a higher realm, a realm of power. This is good. No more suffering. The rose reflects the 144,000 in some way. The horse reflects power and memory. The key is the key of Solomon in front of the body of Christ, and it also reflects frequency. And the body of Christ is the age of Pisces that we all had to grow through. Doesn't matter whether we were Christian or not. Growing through the body of Christ is healing the 7 wounds of Christ, the 7 chakras, and dying at 33 by going up the 33 vertebrae of the Kundalini awakening. When we go through the body of Christ, we die before we die. We go through a major pole shift and we die of an old world, and our ego diminishes and our heart accelerates. It is something that happens on a cellular level and on the ethereal level. It happens within your heart. It happens within your DNA. It happens within your mind. It's like a invisible egg that hatches within everywhere, our bodies, our minds. And it's a light that we never saw before, which literally bounces us to another world. So the person that is asleep in the bed and the person that is dead is reflecting a lower world. Now, those who did not raise their frequency, did not awaken, they may not be real, number one. I do a lot of readings where people have SIM cards in their heads, so God knows. But according to this reading, there are people who will be left behind because they have not healed their traumas, and they have not awoken, and they refuse the voice of the Great Mother, the Holy Spirit. Now, we have Odin holding the head of Mimir at around 8 o'clock. And this cut-off head of Mimir is an oracle. It's an oracle that talks. And this is an allegory that oracles are so important that they are alive even when their heads are cut off. Well, this means that many of us who are stepping into becoming an oracle, stepping into becoming the voice of God, the hands of God, the feet of God, are still alive while many are not. And this doesn't mean, oh, we're better than everybody. I think it just means good job. The you that was a jerk and ignorant is dead, and the people who reflected that are also dead. They may or may not be real. I don't know. But we have become real, like Pinocchio, and we have become alive. And I don't think we should look back and ponder whether we're leaving people behind, because it's a very strange phenomenon what's happening, which is when we shift, other people shift with us. And as we change, other people change. And I don't believe that we actually truly leave people behind, although it seems like that. So whatever the truth is, I don't know. I do see that people who are mentally or spiritually sick will be left behind. But this will happen like a thief in the night, and this is the Hall of Solomon. So the dragon, according to alchemy, is if you get eaten by the dragon, it is a good thing. To be eaten by the dragon means that you are now able to go into the halls of God. If you have not been eaten by the dragon, you cannot go into the hall of God. The eye of the needle is the eye of the dragon. It's a sacred geometrical shape. And the peacock above the dragon is another alchemical symbol of becoming white as snow. All the colors of the peacock feathers blend into one color, which is white. So the white peacock and the black raven reflect that we have learned to balance dark and light. And the peacock and the raven and the dragon is the threefold flame. Learning to balance wisdom, power, and understanding perfectly in alignment and in balance. And learning to balance this so perfectly that we go through the eye of the needle like a laser point, and we become very powerful through this balance. So you are being asked to do some things since you have ascended and been reborn and are being initiated into birthing and using your double. Your double is like a judge. Your double helps people bounce their consciousness to a higher realm. Your double holds a treasure box. This is ushering them into worlds. Now, the treasure box is the token. They will get a token as to whether they go up or down. Some people who lived a wonderful, beautiful, wonderful life for some reason have to experience the lower realm. This is how the universe balances itself. And some people who came from the lower realm are going to be bounced to the higher realm to experience being powerful for a very long time. But you're opening portals and you're using your hands to do so with the white hand. This means that your hands are the hands of God. And the other hand is protecting what is innocent and pure and true. This means seek first the kingdom of God. Now, the baby upside down reflects, do not think on the upside down world. We do not want to bring the dead up with the living. Let the dead bury the dead. The upside down world is negative. A lot of lies, a lot of depression, a lot of anger, a lot of falseness. So seek first the kingdom of God, which means you're going to start imagining sacred geometry. You're going to start thinking about your cave of Brahma within your brain, mandalas, sacred numerology, possibly get into Dr. John Dee and the voice of the angels. Because now you have a job. Now notice that you also look like a tree that's been broken off the tree of the body of Christ with a fish on it. This means that we are no longer in the age of Pisces. We think that that Pisces is linear, and they try to measure where Aquarius is. According to these readings, we ascend there only. If people get sick and die in the age of Pisces, they have to relive the age of Pisces. For those of us who have ascended and are continuing to ascend, we are entering into the age of Aquarius, and the Great Mother is judging us, giving us the token of where we are meant to go in the treasure box. And this is you. The dragonfly on your page has wings on the left page and the right page. This means that your double self can astral travel. It can travel time. You can heal people and raise people from the dead. You can walk on water and raise the dead. Learn to activate by following life energy at this time and leave behind all energy that leads to death, because there will be a time, if you keep practicing this like Doctor Strange, that we will merge as one person. Your higher self and this physical body will become one. And we're being asked to imagine the new world, imagine our new self, speak our new name, embody an invisible flame and imagine it over our bodies, change our diet, and begin to make this shift and do it with thankfulness and joy and passion. But notice the person below you is pointing to this princess or queen, seated on the crown, which is your double. And notice how Christ is pointing toward life. This is life on that side. And then when Christ points to the other side, where the head is cut off and there's someone sick and there's an anointing, there's a holy grail being poured out, below the hand of Christ is those who have to live in the age of Pisces again, and it's sad. But above it is the head of Mimir and Odin and Solomon with the letter S there. The dragon is the baptism of fire. So the bottom world reflects water, which is Pisces, and the top part reflects fire. We are getting our crown. This is the corona crown. And this corona crown is our only way, is to activate our crown chakra and seek first the kingdom of God through gold, the grid of life design. And imagining gold around our head like a sun. Imagine meeting your true love and try to think on that kingdom of heaven, and do not think of the upside down world and the world of the dead, because you will attract the wrong person, is what this reading is telling you. Don't look at that upside down baby in an upside down world. Let your mind focus on life energy and the world of living, and really, really let your double find your true love for you, because we do not want to be pulled back down into the world of ignorance and narcissism, because we have entered Solomon's temple. Let us learn about what Solomon's temple is as an allegory. You know what I know. That Solomon's temple is that we have entered into the sun energy, and that we have left the dark moon behind. This happened within us and outside of ourselves. Solomon's temple is about our twin flame. And look, you have a flame on the left and a flame on the right. This is a promise of a twin flame for you as well. But Spirit is telling you, hey, that person behind you is just hiding behind you, is not as important as this ascension. Let's get past this ascension and be so thankful that we've entered into a new world, and be patient and believe in divine timing when it comes to twin flames. It is the glory of God to conceal spiritual knowledge, and the glory of kings, the spiritually minded, to search for the truth. So it is our job to search for the truth, because the truth is concealed. It is not in the Bible. It is concealed and must be revealed. We are the temple of the living God. You yourself are God's temple, and God's Spirit lives within you. You moved through the body of Christ in the age of Pisces. So Solomon's temple is symbolic of our human body. When God filled the temple at Solomon's dedication, this is symbolic of finding God in the kingdom within you. Solomon's temple is God's glory and presence that has awoken within your heart like an egg that has hatched. We have been resurrected and enlightened. Anyone who has been connected to their higher self, which you have, has entered the living temple of Solomon's temple. We must prepare ourselves for this shift and this enlightenment. It's just going to get stronger and more powerful. And so we have to eat right and think of sacred geometry, think of numerology, think of mandalas, think of frequency, think of sound, think of purification in water and baptism and anointing. Think of comedy and joy, and eating a minimal diet, sun gazing and grounding, yoga. So the Old Testament is about the ego-driven self, and the New Testament is about the higher self, the left side of the brain and the right side of the brain. When the heart dominates the mind, then we begin to hear the higher self, and we hear God, and we hear our double self. And this twin flame is your double self. And your double self can go inside the body of a human being and be part of that twin flame for you. But you are being asked to do great things with your holy temple now, and to focus on it, and to build it up, and to make it strong. He who overcomes, I will make a pillar in the temple of God. And notice how your body looks like a pillar. Yep, you're a pillar in the temple of God. And then you have Solomon right there below you with the Jacob's ladder Christmas tree and the blazing star of Solomon. So look at you. Solomon right below you, the blazing star of Solomon, the Christmas tree. You have the sun. You have the dead fish you left the age of Pisces. Your double is sitting there. You have the mother and you have the raven. You're in a boat. The raven has been released. You're going home. But this isn't about dying, literally. This is about that you are no longer in a prison. You've been set free. And you have been born again. And you have been full of enlightenment. And you are out of the body of Christ, where you were crucified and wounded and had to be reborn and all of this. There's a lot of danger and a lot of negativity in the body of Christ. But we have ascended. And in this place that we are in right now, like a boat, it's a learning place. And in this learning place, if you can learn to obey your double and learn to keep your holy temple and your pillar strong through the threefold flame, wisdom, power, and understanding, then your double will manifest as a twin flame for you. So seek first the kingdom of God and everything will be added unto you. And trust and be excited, because not everyone made it. There are people who were left behind. If there's anything out of alignment in the three main characters in your piece, which represents the threefold flame, it is that you need to be completely obedient and surrender to the dragon. The dragon is in control. Your double is a time traveler. Your double can raise the dead and walk on water and do amazing things. We in the flesh don't have power, so it's not in our power to go look for anything. Wait for divine timing in all things, and you will be just fine. Big hugs and kisses from me to you. I encourage you to study all the symbols in this piece. Look at the numerology. Look at the shapes. Look at which way people are looking. Do they have their eyes closed or opened? Look at everything closely. I want you to do some work here, because this will help you and train you on focusing on the kingdom of God. Use this piece as a map and become Sherlock Holmes and look at all the secrets in here. Do you see the yin and yang under your arm? Both of your arms? I do. There's a lot of secrets in here. I won't tell you everything, but I told you most things. So everything's going to be okay. Focus on life energy, and all the things that you want will be added unto you. My name is Mary Moses. If you would like a reading, go to forestfairy.com.